Joining me now, my very good friend, my brother from another mother, same father, Sergio Talk on Twitter, Sergio Sanchez, at our BFF affiliate there, 710KURV, and he joins us. He's there in McAllen, Texas. And we keep hearing that, you know, we don't hear anything about the border if you listen to the administration. Sergio, we've seen, and you had this on Facebook Live and they took it down, but a record number of illegal entrants last month coming across the border. We keep hearing from police that there are actual, you know, COVID positive people there, that some of them are out and about at Whataburger. Some of them are staying in hotels. Apparently the hotels aren't told that these people are positive. What is going on?
The Dana Show Southern Command is being overrun, my friend.
Wow.
It's good to talk to you again, Dana.
Of course.
This is the top story for our nation just keeps getting bigger and bigger. And the glass towers up in New York continue to ignore the situation. But and I'm grateful that Senator Hawley's pushing the issue. By the way, I found out from a friend that Mayorkas and the current Border Patrol chief, who has roots in the Rio Grande Valley, they'll be here pretty soon. I'm sure wearing masks, because we have a COVID situation on the ground. And I've got friends checking in. And a big thank you to my producer, Freddie, because we were trying to gather notes earlier. The county is experiencing a spike in COVID positive cases. I know that local clinics have also, and hospitals have attended to COVID cases. And now I got friends checking in telling us that the numbers that the county, Hidalgo County, where McAllen is, the numbers are possibly being blended. It's the illegal immigrants that were released and tested, plus the local residents. I have another loyal listener, thank you for checking in and giving me a report from the bus station here in McAllen. See, the bus station is what local leaders, is a place that local leaders in McAllen have depended for the longest time to transport these folks who are released by Border Patrol. And let me take a step back, because I'm assuming too much people listening nationwide. Let me explain how this works. Border Patrol will, I would say, catch, but they're really not catching these days. The illegal immigrants by the groups of hundreds and thousands per day, but each group is like several hundred people. Wow. Many of them are little children that were sent on their own. They're waiting. They swim the river, told by the cartels and the human smugglers, who charge them a lot of money, by the way, to cross at a certain point that they know will be processed by Border Patrol. They cross and they kind of sit around and wait for Border Patrol to show up. They don't fear Border Patrol. The ones who fear Border Patrol are, as we call them, the getaways. The ones who, because they have a criminal past, they might be coming in for, I don't know, to compromise national security. They're drug runners, whatever. While the Border Patrol, our agents are down here, and the local chief, Chief Hastings, had told me that about 47, almost 50% of his staff is doing nothing but processing these large groups of hundreds of illegal immigrants who just come here and sit and wait to be processed. And they say the magic words that they were coached to say, credible fear or asylum. In other words, they want to get in line with the 1.3 million individuals that are already in line in this country.
Wow.
Hoping to get an initial asylum hearing, because there are no tent courts around here with flat screen televisions to hear them immediately and send them back, or to send them back as we did under Trump immediately, and then give them an appointment to come to a tent court with a flat screen television for them to make their case, and they would be automatically denied because they're not religious or political asylees or refugees. Mm. They're economic migrants. But the Border Patrol, half of them down here, they're busy processing these folks. The other getaways, who have probably some of them have nefarious intentions, they run through the brushland and go north. In the meantime, we have seen record, just jaw-dropping record numbers. I got a friend from Border Patrol, just the McAllen sector office. We have 9 Border Patrol sector offices, and the 2 counties are deep South Texas. Brownsville, that's Cameron mm-hmm. County, Hidalgo County, we have 9 of them. McAllen, daily. These used to be weekly figures, if not monthly, many months ago. Daily, 2,000 just McAllen alone. Rio Grande sector, which is Brownsville, McAllen, then west of us, Rio Grande City, about 3,000. And a good chunk of those, about a third of those, a quarter of those, are kids sent on their own into this country to meet up with a family member. And anywhere between 20 to 30%,
wow,
best guesstimate, is COVID positive.
Wow. And
as they are released, they say the magic words, credible fear. Don't send me back. Asylum. Hmm. They're released. Some of them, I've heard Border Patrol tell me, some of them, they don't even get a court date. Those papers are with a court date. They just get just released. They're alone. One Border Patrol agent with 200, 300 people that the process. It's beyond ridiculous. It's criminal. This is the height of compromising our national security. We have no border. We have a DHS chief in the administration says the border is closed. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Where?
Where is it?
It's
yeah. Not maybe in Canada, but not there in RGV Valley. Talking to our friend.
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Talking to Sergio Sanchez down at KORV, our BFF affiliate down there, and he's seen all of this firsthand. I want to ask you about this because I'm fascinated about this. We've dealt with the issue of big tech silencing people over any kind of vaccine discussion. But apparently you were doing a Facebook Live. You were talking about all of this just last night. Tell me what happened. What happened to that? What happened to that video you were doing?
A couple of days back, I was driving. That's my neighborhood, by the way. And that's where most of my staff lives in North McAllen. And I was driving with my boy. And it's a property that we've known for years was a processing place for agriculture. And it was a fence. It's like one of those mesh hurricane fences. And you can see through it. And all of a sudden, I see this black tarp on it. So I start making phone calls. Why is a black tarp on this thing? We see right through all the way, like 2 acres down. And my friends tell me the city is about to process and set up a tent facility, an overflow facility for Sister Norma. Sister Norma is Catholic Charities here in Deep South Texas. Catholic Charities is the organization that takes these folks who are released by Border Patrol because they claim they want an asylum hearing. They have to be released by the thousands. And this Sister Norma Pimentel in downtown McAllen, she has this respite center in downtown McAllen for years now. This going back to Obama.
Mm-hmm. I've been down there. Well, I think that's when you and I were kind of first around each other. Was down, I think, at probably maybe her facility, because that's when a lot of reporters were down there. Ooh.
That was at a church in downtown McAllen, a few blocks away, is her respite center. Contracted with the city of McAllen to provide the space for her to shower and give some clothing to, shoes. And these folks normally jump on the buses and leave town to wherever it is that they're going. They don't stay here, but now they're staying here because it's way, way too many of them. And they needed an overflow facility to hold some of these folks who were COVID positive. And that's what happened. In an afternoon, they set up several tents. It was fire department, city crews. You could see the city equipment, and they put this long, long black tarp to cover the fence so that no one would see what's going on. So that evening, I got out of my vehicle, parked at the gas station across the street, and just took as best I could a Facebook Live video to show folks, okay, it's now spilling into the neighborhoods in North McAllen. Following morning is when I find out that it was a COVID positive overflow place to try to keep these folks from walking the streets. Now, nothing would have prevented it, I'm sure, if they demanded to leave that facility. They're not under arrest.
Right.
They're just kindly being held by the city. And there's so many questions that have branched off of this.
And I have other...
And one of the biggest ones is...
Well, I mean, why would the government not want you, who is a resident, and you're talking about an overflow facility, literally in your neighborhood, why would they not want that on Facebook? Why would that get taken down?
PC politics. What is it then? Oh yeah. That lady that was, remember Ted Cruz came down here to the Donna facility?
Mm-hmm.
And he was trying to take video of the facility. He says, respect the dignity, sir. Respect the dignity of the migrants and all this stuff. Oh my goodness. They are crippled by hypersensitivities that they don't do their job that they were called to protect our community. Oh, it's gone, Dana. There were plenty of phone calls to City Hall, and people complained. You can just imagine, in less than 48 hours, it's gone. I drove by the facility just to confirm that it's gone. Yes, it's gone.
Wow.
The black tarp covering the entire fence is still there, but it's empty. They moved that camp, that holding camp for these folks, to Ansel Duas Park, which is right next to that long international bridge that extends to Mexico, that Border Patrol is using to hold thousands of folks who they just caught and processed to bring in and bit by bit try to interview and give them a piece of paper for a court hearing that they will not appear to. And eventually they release, and it's Sister Norma Catholic Charities that does this COVID testing and has maybe between 20-30% of these folks testing positive, and they have to be held somewhere. And they're being held by, my suspicion is, and I still haven't gotten a clear indication of this, but you might remember how, what was it, $85, $86 million the administration set aside for hotels.
Hotels
to hold these family units. Well, NGOs, non-government organizations, aka Catholic Charities, and other organizations that are helping these folks that are released just at bus stations and onto the streets by Border Patrol because they can't be held. They're being held at these hotels, housed at these hotels for, I was told, about 5 days quarantine, which last I checked, I think you and I, if we come down with COVID, you and I would, as U.S. citizens, be quarantined for 10 to 14 days.
Right.
But anyway,
it's just unbelievable to me that this is happening. Talking to our very, very good friend, Sergio Sanchez, our affiliate KURV, you hear him fill in for me. He's the only reason I'm able to take any time off, and for that I'm eternally grateful. One last question for you. I got to get your reaction to, for everybody across the country. You're in McAllen. I mean, this is your home. What do you make of, what's your reaction to the administration not paying any attention to what's going on at the border? But, you know, they're very, very concerned about what's happening in Florida with Ron DeSantis, you know, because that's hampering their ability to control the pandemic, Sergio, but not what's happening at the border.
Political betrayal. This area of Texas has been Democrat for the longest time. This area of Texas, which is slowly but surely turning purple and headed towards the red, by the way. But I'd call it political betrayal, because you got all these Democrats, from the county judges and commissioners to a lot of people at City Hall and cities down here. No matter how loud they yell and scream, the White House is not listening to them. I'd say political betrayal.
My goodness. This is just insane to see. We're going to have you on again to talk with you about this, to keep track of everything. This is our very good friend, Sergio Sanchez. You can follow him on Twitter at Sergio Talk. And of course, you can listen to him on 710 KURV, our affiliate down there in McAllen, Texas. He's been seeing all of this firsthand, unlike the border. What is it? I guess the border chief, I don't know, VP Kamala Harris. She's never been down there. She went to where the wall was. Mm-hmm. She didn't go down to RGV. Sergio, so good to talk with you, my friend. We're gonna have you back for folks, so you can tell everybody exactly what's happening, because you know the CNNs and ABCs and NBCs and MSNBCs definitely aren't. Godspeed, my friend. So good to talk with you.
Big hug, Dana. Big hug.
Take care. Thank you. Of course.